I want to thank you for the initiative you have taken. Mombasa is the gateway of Kenya. Apart from Nairobi, by airport, Mombasa is both by air and by sea. And therefore, you form a very important economic zone that we are all proud of. If Mombasa sinks, the nation sinks. Interestingly enough, if Mombasa sinks, even the neighboring countries sink. So you occupy a very unique position in ensuring that the economy flows. I take note of the many developmental projects on the card. What you can do in the way of budget performance, complete them. Any other pending bills that may have been left, once the formula is decided upon, let it be the first charge on your books of account. So it doesn't have to become a recurring audit query at any given time. For us, this is a good forum. You have had an opportunity to express yourself to the people of Mombasa and at large the people of Kenya through the media. They've captured you on television, on media waves, all over the country, internationally. Therefore, you have this is a place to have an opportunity to exonerate yourself on issues that you might have not expressed yourself properly when you, the auditors were with you at that moment. You have an opportunity to do so. That's why I encourage all governors to come. This is the forum where you can articulate those things. And like many of my colleagues have said, I think when it comes to gender, you've done very well. And unlike last year, and you know what I'm referring to, this year is much better and extremely, absolutely clear. And I had a very easy time last evening when I was going flipping through the financial statements and notes to the statement. They were very readable. Easily, you could easily follow the narrative, what was going on, and you can actually see where the problems were. And I was more interested in how you approach to resolve those problems, and you've explained here before this committee. When you go back, go with the same enthusiasm that I've seen you on many occasions, on television, how you took COVID-19 almost on a personal level. Continue doing it until that curve is flattened. We need to flatten that curve, and when you do your first kidney transplant, I'll be quite happy to come, because I think I'm one of the pioneers. When we did the kidney transplant in this country with the late Professor Nelson Awori, he was a surgeon, and I was a physician, and our patient Coco, it was quite a miracle then, because it was rare to do those kidney transplants. Now it's common, and it's being done at the county level. It's quite a common thing. The only thing I would have cautioned is ensure that the equipment in monitoring pre- and post-operative period is absolutely up to date, so that there are no lapses. You don't lose any patient as a result of those dynamics.